Happy Taco Tuesday. Welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, hi, I'm Tori. Nice to meet you. So something you all should know about me is that I really, really love music. It is a huge part of my life. And something I don't really talk about, and I'm surprised I haven't talked about yet, is worship music. So I don't listen to worship music all the time. I listen to a lot of what they would call secular music, because I think music is beautiful. It doesn't necessarily need to be a bad thing. But I tend to reserve worship music for certain situations. So I'm more of a situational, circumstantial worship music listener rather than an everyday worship music listener. And so because I'm more of someone who listens to worship music at a designated time, I definitely pay attention to the words that I'm listening to, the words that I might be singing, and the instrumental tracks behind the vocals definitely matter to me as well. So yeah, I just wanted to share these songs with you guys. I will leave the links to all of them in the description box below. I unfortunately can't play them for you because of copyright, but that's okay because you can look it up and hear the full thing with no interruptions. So coming in at number 5, we have Glory and Wonder by Mosaic MSC. So this song is so beautiful. I feel like it starts off slow and then it gets into this really belty power ballad, right? And the whole idea of this song is how our glory and wonder for God, how we stand in awe of how powerful He is, that it is stronger than anything else, any other negative feeling that we could possibly feel. And so one of my favorite lines in the song is, "Take this heart and show it how to beat. All you are is who I want to be. I give you my love completely." And I feel like this is such a great line of surrender and giving it all to God and letting Him teach us how we should live. Letting Him teach us how our heart should beat. Coming in at number 4 is Another in the Fire from Hillsong United. Oh man, this song gives me chills. On chills, on chills, especially when I'm in a worship mode and my heart is open. I just feel like it definitely reminds us that there is another in the fire fighting with us, that we are never alone. So my favorite part of the song is actually the bridge, and I feel like it just makes me feel so protected and safe in God's hands. And it says, "I can see the light in the darkness as the darkness bows to Him. And I can hear the roar in the heavens as the space between wears thin. I can feel the ground shake beneath us as the prison walls cave in. Nothing stands between us." And this idea of God being right there with me makes me feel so strong and so powerful. So love this song. Coming in at number 3 is the song Make Room from, I believe it's called The Church Will Sing. And I actually learned this one on piano. It's very pretty. And it's simply about making room in your heart and in your life for God to do what He wants to do with you. And one of my favorite verses in the Bible is the one where it says, "Well done, my good and faithful servant." And I just feel like the heart of a servant is one that is more than willing to let God in, that makes room in their heart to let God in and transform their lives. And so the lyrics are very simple, but I guess my favorite part is the main refrain of the entire song, which is, "And I will make room for you to do whatever you want to, to do whatever you want to." And this repeats over and over again, but it's like a really nice meditative prayer to the Lord. Coming in at number 2 is the song Starlight, which I've mentioned on this channel before. It is one of my all-time favorite worship songs, and that's because it builds on itself. It is extremely powerful. I think the message is beautiful. And really, it's just talking about how, no matter how dark things can get, that God will always be our light in the dark to rely on. Now, it's really hard for me to find a favorite line in this song because I love every line in this song. But if I had to kind of pick the most impactful part, it's definitely the part that's repeated at the beginning and the end, and that's, "You're like starlight in the dark, endless miles can't conceal you, and every glimmer is a spark catching fire as you break through." And I just love that visual because I think it only takes one little spark to set a fire. And the same way, it takes one spark in our lives, one touch of heaven, one hug from Jesus to just transform and set off a chain of reaction events that will cause the miraculous to happen. Coming in at number one is my personal all-time favorite worship song because it just gets me so excited to just do life. But the song is Surely Goodness and Mercy by Israel Houghton. So it's very carefree, it's loose, and it just repeats the lines of that scripture in the Bible that says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all of the days of my life. And it's such a happy song. It puts me in such a great mood, and I hope it does the same for you if you choose to listen to it. But just remembering that when we have the Lord in our lives, goodness and mercy follows us all of the days of our life, and how blessed we are to have that really reminds me of that. And that is why it is my number one favorite all-time worship song. Let me know if you guys listen to any of these songs. Please comment down below which one your favorite is or what your favorite worship song is so I can go check it out myself. Don't forget to go check out my t-shirt series on Corinthians Corner if you want a little more Jesus in your week. Those videos are uploaded every Friday. And be sure to subscribe to this channel if you want to see more content because I post Christian-related content every Taco Tuesday. Also, be sure to follow me on my Instagram at mygodmoments if you want to see more Jesus in your feed and my own personal walk with the Lord. I hope you guys have a fantastic week and that mercy and goodness follows you all the days of your life. And I will see you all next time. Bye!